Next topic, casual ordering of messages. In continuation with the various clocks like lampposts and vector clocks, casual ordering of messages coming to the point where there is a necessity. In short of delivering the message in an order. So let's understand first what is casual ordering of messages. This casual ordering of messages actually deals with the problem of maintaining the same casual relationship that holds among message sending event with the corresponding message receiving event. That means, in other words, we can say, if there are two messages, M1 and M2, which are sent in sequence, we should ensure that the recipient of message M1 must be before M2, right? So if you say send off M1 is happened before send off M2, right? Send off M1 happened before send off M2, then every recipient of both the messages M1, M2 must receive it in an order M1 and M2. That is, must receive M1 before M2, right? So in this distributed environment, casual ordering of messages not done automatically. So we need to employ some protocols to ensure this casual ordering of message. For casual ordering of message, why we want to have such a mechanism? Since it is not automatically done, we are in the position to enforce it manually by way of devising some algorithm. Why? In distributed environment, you know, the databases having redundancy kept in many places. Later, one scenario we want to see with an example. Here, I have process P1. I have process P2. And P3, right? Now, P1, P2, P3, amongst these three processes, now P1 initiate an event E11, which sends a message to P3, right? This is message one. Meanwhile, after some time, P1 sends another message to P2. Right, then P2 sends a message to P3, right? So there are three messages, which is, this is the first message and this is the second message, right? And this is the third message, let's say, right? The message what is sent by P1, here E11 is sending message M1, let's say. This M1 gets delayed. M1, there is a delay in delivering. Delay of M1. At this circumstance, what will happen? The message sent by P2, which is M2, delivered to the P3. So before receiving M1, P3 receives M2, which is wrong, right? So this is the scenario where actually the casual ordering is violated, right? So what should happen? What we have to do is, we have to make the M2 to wait till M1 get delivered, okay? So instead of delivering M2 at this moment, the process should be postponed. The message delivery of second should be postponed, right, till M1 get received by P3. Okay, there are two protocols which takes care of this particular problem, right? So first protocol, which is Biermann-Skipper-Stephenson protocol, which is simply called as BSS protocol, right? This protocol is making use of the technique broadcasting. Okay. The second protocol is the Seifert-Eagley Santos protocol, SCS protocol, we can say in abbreviation. But this SCS protocol do not use any broadcasting. This is a major difference between these two. Okay. Now let's come and see what is the basic idea behind these two protocols. Here, both the protocols is to deliver a message to a process only if the message immediately preceding it is delivered. And then there will be always here the vector clock is used, right? So a vector accompanying each message contains the necessary information to decide whether there exist a preceding messages. With the Stephenson protocol, that is BSS algorithm protocol, right? So I have so BSS algorithm at the center end, before broadcasting a message M, a process PI increments the vector. There is a time vector VT PI of I, right? And a timestamp M. So both are incremented. Receiver end la enna agum, process PJ, suppose on receive the broadcast aayirundha the message illaya, then a process PJ upon receiving the message M timestamped VTM, right? So inge timestamp vandu inda vector timestamp, appo idhukku vandu timestamp enna na the message ku VTM, right? So it receives the message illaya, appo it will verify the VTM of the message and delays its delivery until in the rendu condition satisfy ensuring the first condition A ensures process PJ has received all other messages from PI. Second condition ensures PJ received all those messages received by PI before sending M, right? The broadcast. So this is how actually in the rendu condition paaka or mari clumsy a irukum, but when we see the example we can easily understand, right? Now the delayed message are queued at each process in a queue in a sorted order. So that queue, the queue la the messages will be kept in a sorted order of its vector time. Suppose concurrent messages comes, it will be sorted by their time of receipt. Time of receipt based panni adha buffer pannuvom for concurrent messages, right? So when the message is delivered at process PI PJ, VTPJ, which is the vector clock of PJ, is updated according to the vector clock rule IR2. Rule 1, rule 2. Rule 1 is for event of similar process. Rule 2 for message sending processes. Anga vandu namu what the point here, right? So in simply speaking, at every process, it should be ensured that the process receiving the messages, where it receive a message M, it should receive all other messages of him before him. Adhe madri process should ensure the recipient are received all other those messages received before received by the sender process before sending message M, right? So this is what actually these two, this is very particular in the coming to the example of BSS. Three processes as usual in the space P1, P2, P3. Ipo P1, P3, because who is the source of the first sender? P3 at point of event 31, first event is sending a message, broadcasting a message, okay, message M1. இங்க பாருங்க, இப்போ at the time of event E31, the vector clock of P3 is 001. இது நம்ம sending a message, it increments its position. Okay. Now, இதுதான் clock value. இப்போ the vector, இதுதான் actually vector timestamp. Okay, VTM என்னது? VT M of P3. இது வந்து என்ன பண்ணுது? 001னு send பண்ணுது. Broadcast பண்ணுது. Right? So, for either the messages targeting P1. If P1 is a message, tha. But na, P2 is a process. That's why we broadcast. Broadcasting is a not only the recipient, targeted recipient, all other processes who are all are the, on the space will receive. On the basis la, inga P2 ingeyu receive agudhu. இங்கேயும் ரிசீவ் ஆ இங்கே வந்து லேட்டாக ரிசீவ் ஆகுது பாருங்க அந்த டைம் எப்போ அனுப்பிச்சோ அப்போ இல்லை கொஞ்சம் லேட்டாக தான் ரிசீவ் ஆகுது ரைட் ஓகே ஸோ ஆன் ரெசிப்ட் யூ லுக் அட் ஹியர் த டைம் ஸ்டாம்ப் இந்த மெசேஜோட ரிசீவிங் டைம் ஸ்டாம்ப் என்ன சென்டிங் டைம் ஸ்டாம்ப் டிஎம் தான் இங்கே இருக்கும் இங்கேயும் அதே மாதிரி இருக்கும் 001 நவ் ஆஃப்டர் சம் டைம் திஸ் இஸ் ஃபார் M1 இல்லையா இங்கே ஆஃப்டர் சம் டைம் ப்ராசஸ் P2 சென்ஸ் அ மெசேஜ் right to both P3 and P1 திருப்பி இது ரெண்டு broadcast ஆகுது இல்லையா இப்போ P2 simply sends a message by updating its own clock அப்ப இதோட clock update பண்ணும்போது பாருங்க already it received a message M1 broadcaster's message இதுக்கு தெரியும் அப்போ in the 001 the receipt clock receipt increment panni anupom 0 is for P1 already P3 la or message irukku 1 irukku appo P2 idoda position increment pannu right okay so it increments its own corresponding entry so that the clock vector timestamp is 011 so this is what actually in the broadcaster message attached with the broadcaster message So 011 011. Now this message M2, which is having vector timestamp 011, is received on P1 before M2 get received. இப்போ இது இங்கே ரிசீவ் ஆயிடுச்சு இது என்ன 011 இது 011 ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ரிசீவ் ஆயிடுச்சு ரைட் பட்டு இங்க 001 ரிசீவ் ஆகல ரைட் அப்ப என்ன பண்ணும் இட் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் தட் தி வெக்டார் டைம் இஸ் சம்திங் மோர் இல்லையா வெக்டார் டைம் இஸ் சம்திங் மோர் ரைட் சோ தென் இட் இஸ் என்ஷூரிங் தட் தி பி கண்டிஷன் என்ஷூர் பண்ணும் ரைட் தி P1 ரிசீவ்ட் timestamp is more than the timestamp of the broadcast already broadcasted right 011 விட அதிகமா இருக்கு இல்லையா அப்ப என்ன பண்ணோம் this message is going to be buffered until இதவிட கம்மியா இருக்கிற timestamp வர்ற வரைக்கும் வெயிட் பண்ணும் இப்போ இதவிட கம்மியா ஒரு timestamp ரிசீவ் ஆயிடுச்சு இல்லையா after some time அப்போ this 0 is lesser this is lesser and this is equal okay no problem So by ordering, casual ordering, this is lesser than this one. So if I receive another, say on receiving this, the P1 understand that there is some more process, some more 001 message to get delivered after M1, right? On the, now this receive, Paniko, Leya, okay? Similarly, in the case is delivered, but P3 accept this message because இதோட time stamp, இங்க existing time stamp ஓட இது next time stamp ஆ இருக்குது just next one. So அது accept பண்ணு, delay பண்ணாது. Right? So this is how actually the BSS algorithm works. Right? Another example, in continuation of the previous one, right? You look at here, இப்போ இங்க M1, this is M1 and this is M2. After M1 get delivered, M2 delivered to P1 at the timestamp of 011. Right. Next, the P1 sends a message. P1 sends a message. So it broadcasting to both P2 kum broadcast pannu, P3 kum broadcast pannu. When P1 starts sending a message, the timestamp, look at this one. Already, current timestamp of message receipt is 011. Apo, for P1 entry, the corresponding P1 entry alone is incremented. Right? அப்ப என்ன அர்த்தம் ஏற்கனவே ஃபர்ஸ்ட் மெசேஜ் இஸ் சென்ட் பை பி த்ரீ செகண்ட் மெசேஜ் பை பி டூ இப்போ தேர்டாக இது அனுப்புது பி ஒன் ரைட் ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் கரெக்ட் கம்யூனிகேட்டர் நவ் ஆன் ரிசீவிங் த மெசேஜ் தி மெசேஜ் வித் லோயர் டைம் ஸ்டாம்ப் ரிசீவ்டு 011 தென் திஸ் இஸ் பஃபர்ட் அண்ட் டிலேடு டெலிவரி ஓகே இப்போ பாருங்க எம் இங்கே எம் த்ரீ இப்போ தான் டெலிவர் ஆகும் ஒன்ஸ் ஆஃப்டர் 011 Right? So this is how actually the third message delivered. And coming to the fourth message. The fourth message broadcast achana, automatic 211 is inga 011 maintain avudhu queue la. Inga receive aayirukkaradhu 211. Receipt will be buffered till 111 received. So once after P2 received 111, then it start accepting 211, which is message M4, right? So this is how actually the buffered broadcasting helps in ordering, maintaining the casual ordering of messages, right? So this is what actually BSS algorithm. This is how BSS algorithm works.